This is Brand Insider. We take you inside brands, thought leaders, and innovators to discover strategies, insight, and perspective that help drive success in today's market. He is the former CMO of Kodak turned global business consultant and best-selling author Jeffrey Hazlett. His new book, Running the Gauntlet, spurs on marketers and business leaders to act as change agents.
Well, there's a number of ways that you got to affect change, and there's five real reasons that people fail in order to drive change. And the first one, and one of the most important, is fear. Those first few seconds of fear, of willing to not be a beginner. They're so afraid to begin in the process that we get stymied. Think about if you've ever done bungee jumping or done something that you were afraid to do. It's that standing on the precipice and standing on the edge and being afraid to take that step off. But once you do it, the exhilaration, the fun, the excitement that comes from it is just tremendous. So for all of us, no matter whether we're new or we're old, and whether we're experienced or inexperienced, we all have these first seconds of fear, and it's about driving through that fear in order to get to that exhilarating portion of our jobs. In order to drive change, you've got to drive through the fear, but you also have to learn to do other things. One of those is to take risk, calculated risk. I mean, come on. We're in marketing for the most part. No one's going to die. I mean, the worst that could happen, we'll get a paper cut from a press release, or maybe, oh my gosh, we've spelled something wrong on an ad. But by and large, no one's going to die. So we have to learn to take risk. We have to be transparent. Talk about the elephants in the room. I mean, we all see them there. They're standing there. In fact, I like to eat elephants. They taste good. And then we want to make sure that we're focusing in on the mood of the company as well. Because if you can't change the mood, if you believe your best days are behind you and not in front of you, you'll be dead before you begin. I've described transparency in a number of ways. Let me give you an example in a small business, because a lot of marketers that are watching this are small businesses. And when we're doing well in our business, sometimes we are afraid to tell everything about what's going on. Yet, you know, when we buy a new Mercedes, I think our employees know that things are going pretty well. When things start coming in COD, I think they know that things aren't working as well. So my belief is to be as transparent as possible in your business so that everyone knows everything about your business so that they can make better decisions and to be vocal about that. I remember one time years ago, I owned a printing business and I was really running short on cash. It was a very tight. We were growing very heavily, but growing really short on cash. And my manager went out and bought a truckload, a semi-truckload of paper because he got a great deal on it. Well, I didn't have the cash to be able to do it. And I had to go to him, why did you do that? And he goes, we had such a great deal. Had he known I was short on cash, even though it was a great deal, he wouldn't have made that decision. And so that was my lack of being transparent, of being afraid that he was going to know that we were having some tough times. He made a big mistake. And in essence, I made the bigger mistake because I didn't be transparent with him. In everything that we do, there's an action cycle of what I call mutual conditions of satisfaction. On one side, there's a performer. On the other side, there's a customer. In everything, whether it's in our personal relationships or our business relationships, and it's about driving those mutual conditions of satisfaction, or what I call promises. I mean, when you make a promise to your kid to take them to Disneyland or Disney World, it's a promise. It's not like a suggestion. And so we need to be able to do that in our business. Let me give you an example. If you go to McDonald's, you pull up to McDonald's, you pull up to the first speaker, you shout out your order. You pull up to the first window, you give them your money. You pull up to the second window expecting your food. But 9 times out of 10, this is what happens to you. Let's see if it happens to you the way it happens to me. The 14-year-old assistant manager comes over and knocks on the window, and I roll down my window and they says, I'm sorry, sir, your food's not quite ready. We'll bring it to you in a few moments. If you just pull right over here to this little parking spot, and they try to put you into what I call parking purgatory. And pretty soon I turned back to him and said, no, thank you, I'll wait. And I rolled my window back up. And so pretty soon the 16-year-old manager comes over and knocks on my window, and we go through the same situation. He says, sir, if you don't mind pulling forward, you're gonna hold the people up. I go, I don't mind. And so what I do is I tell them, I said, look, we made a promise, you and I. You were a performer, I'm the customer. I gave you my order, you took it. I gave you my money, you took it. I'm here to get my food. I'm not taking this kind of service. See, unless you're renegotiating the promises, you're offering me a Big Mac or maybe an apple pie or one of those McMinty shakes that I like so much, then maybe I'll pull over here. But if you're not, I don't mind waiting, and I roll my window back up. See, it's about keeping mutual conditions of satisfaction. It's about driving people to be better customers and better performers as you as a customer. And so it's really about keeping promises. In our business, I have promises to my employees, they have promises to me, and promises to my shareholders, and certainly promises to all my customers and my vendors. So it's that mutual condition of satisfaction, that action cycle that bonds us together.
Well, that wraps up this edition of Brand Insider. Thanks for watching, and be sure to let us hear from you. Brand Insider, are you in?